All right, friends, what I have for you today is a Hello World project to help get you going with Blend4Web. Now, the idea behind this project is to make it as simple as possible while still using the key components of Blend4Web, that being HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and of course, the scene you make in Blender. So first of all, if you go to this website, and I will link to it in the description, I might even put a little box for you, like right in the middle, and you can download the files for this project. So just click this link right here. The project will download. While that's downloading, I'm going to show you the simple scene in Blender that I use in this project. It may look a little complicated, but it's very simple. Mostly what you see is this spherical image I placed in the background, and I'm going to go ahead and make that invisible so you can see what's left. And if we take a look at the camera, you can see I've added a little animation. And that strange little pointer there, I have parented that to the camera just for my own visual aid, so I can see where the camera's pointing. I find that useful. And it doesn't show up when you do the render. The reason it does not show up is if I click on the object and come to objects and come down here, I have here checkmarked do not export. If you are new to Blender, go ahead and search on YouTube Blender for Noobs. There's a great series out that helps you get going in Blender. Filter your search results for the past year, so you're current. All right, I'm going to take that zip file. I'll show you how I handle zip files. My way is weird, but I just drag it right out like that. And then I'm going to go ahead and unzip it. I have 7-zip. You can extract all, or if you have a third-party program, you can do that. So I'm just going to extract it out, and there's a 2 there because I've got another one sitting there, and I'm going to go ahead and delete that. And I'm going to open this file and open this file. Now, these are the files we are concerned about. So this is the project. In order to properly place this, I want to show you the project manager in the Blend4Web SDK. So from Blender, go ahead and click your, make sure this says Blend4Web, and click your export tab, and hit open SDK right here. And so that's going to open that up. And what we're going to do is go ahead and go to project manager. And here you see a list of all of the applications that shipped with your SDK, and we're going to place ours on the list for ease of access. So we're going to click new, and we're going to name our project Hello World. And I don't think we need a title at this time. Now, if we were starting from scratch, you'd want to create some of your starter files, but we're not going to do that. But we are going to bundle our project into one single directory. So once your settings look like this, go ahead and click create, and it's going to tell you what it has done. It created a directory in appsdev/hello-world. So if we come to our root directory of Blend4Web and go to appsdev, you're going to see your Hello World directory, and there's nothing there except for a project file. So let's pull up the zip file that you downloaded, and what we're going to do is just load these into our directory. So we can just copy those in. Now, something that's going to happen is your, as you can see, all of these have a link underneath them. So what this is going to do is it's going to look for an HTML file with the name Hello World. And once that exists, it's going to give you a link there. So we will go ahead and rename that. I was going to just name it that to begin with, but I thought, well, why not pass that little lesson along? Let's go ahead and rename that file, the index.html. to Hello World. And then if we come back to our project manager and refresh it, it's going to have the link to your project right there. So if we open that up, now your app is running on your local server. Now to recap how to find your project, you're going to open the SDK, go to project manager, and click on your link, and that's going to open your project. Now to find it in the folder structure, you're going to go to the root directory of Blend4Web, appsdev, hello world, and here are all your files. Now let's go under the hood and see what all these files are. And so to take a look at what these files are, these first three you're just not going to worry about at this point in your career. And this is the image that I use for a texture as the background, and I should mention that it is a power of two dimensional image, or a pot image. So I believe this image is 40, what are the dimensions of this image? We can find out. So let's go like this. Properties, details. So we can see that this image is a 4096 by 2048, and those are powers of two. And to understand what powers of two are, if you start with two and double it, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512. So typically, WebGL doesn't function well with non-power of two dimensions. So it's a WebGL thing, so try and make your... Try anytime you're putting textures into Blender for the purposes of Blend4Web exports, try and use power of two dimensions in your images. And this second image is the same image over again. The reason it's there is because for convenience sake, I packed the files. If you go to external data, you can see I've got that checked to automatically pack into .blend. And so when I did the export, it exported that image again. And that's not always the most ideal way to do it. Sometimes it's better to link to it externally. And I have just done that for convenience in this case. And then we have our b4w.min.js. That's your JavaScript engine. That's the Blend4Web engine that does all your work. And then when you export your JSON file from Blender, it's going to create this bin file and this JSON file. And you don't need to edit those. You just need to know that they are there and they need to be part of your project. And so the next thing, let's bring up hello world.html. And these are sort of the key ones. These three right here, CSS, HTML, and JavaScript. And I have these open over here. So the elements of your HTML file, basically you have a link to your style sheet, which is the hello world.css. And then a link to the Blend4Web engine. And this is a link to your JavaScript file. And then down here we have the div ID. And the div ID, what that is, let's take a look at this. That is this background it's like a background container that the application runs in. The JavaScript file loads the app into this div. You can see it's opened and closed and there's nothing inside. But if we go to your JavaScript file, we see that it targets that div right here and loads your scene into that container. And if we look at your CSS file, we see that it also targets that div and tells it to remain fixed and be 100%. And the top left corner is aligned to the top left of your screen. And then we also have the overlay container. And if we look at the CSS file, the ID is targeted with the hashtag overlay container. And these rules apply to that. That's what gives us this, it's scrollable and centered. And one cool thing you should know is the way that's colored. So RGBA stands for red, green, blue, alpha. And you probably know what these numbers mean, but just in case you don't know what that is, that's what gives it this alpha. If it was a 1, it would be completely opaque, and a 0 would be completely transparent. But now we have this nice translucent semi-transparency that we were trying to achieve. And the JavaScript file is fairly simple. If you want to delve into this code, I've gone ahead and put some comments to kind of explain what the code does. And also, your SDK comes with documentation. And so I've put the address here. And the way to find that is if you go to your SDK. Where did I go? Let's go back to the root of our SDK. And come to API reference. And you can read right here. And then here, like for example, if I wanted to know what app means, I could come over here and read what app does. And so you should know where the documentation is. Now that we've got your project up and running, let's make sure you know how to make it your own. I want to make sure you know how to make changes and get it exported. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and just add a random object here. And I'm going to show you how to do the export. So we're going to go export JSON. We're going to go ahead and click run in viewer. That's a little tool that will help you tweak your project. So we're going to hit export and it's going to load it into the viewer. And what we see is that great big huge cube is right in our face. So let's make a quick change to that. Let's scale that down just to show that we made a change. And let's try that again. File, export, JSON. We can kill the first one. And so there we go. That's our change. This gives you the options of tweaking some elements. So for example, if I wanted to adjust the lighting, I could come here and adjust the lighting in the scene. And it doesn't affect the picture in the background because that's set to shadeless and it's not affected by light. And if you had used some of these other settings in your scene, you could adjust those as well. So we can go ahead and close that and we can go ahead and check the scene in our project manager because we were just looking at the JSON export only. So let's go ahead and look at the full project. Now you know how to customize this Blender scene and make it your own. All right, one little detail I wanted to cover is the F12 key in your browser, whether it's Chrome or Firefox. If you hit the F12 key, it opens this console and will display any loading errors you might have. So anytime something's not working when you try and load it, go ahead and hit that first and you will get a record of what's happening. So in this case, I refreshed and it just navigated to there. And if you've got something wrong, missing files or warnings, you'll get that here. And so that's kind of a useful little piece of information that will help you along your way. Now, while we're delving into the SDK, I would like to show you a couple of other example applications that ship with your SDK. So starting from the index file of your SDK, we're going to look at some of the basic applications that will help you as you start your path in Blend4Web. So we're going to check out this balloons, this little application. And what this is, we've got normal HTML, and this is a little bit opposite of the Hello World demo that we did. This one plays over the surface. So we have a button here that's defined with CSS and HTML, and when clicked, it plays a little demo there. And this is all within Blender. And let's see, another one you should look at is the cartoon interior. Now this is a nice little demo. We have the ability to place these objects into the scene and we can select them and turn them. And this uses elements of HTML and CSS. If the JSON file doesn't load at all, you can still see these buttons because they're defined like a normal web page would be built. And then let's look at one more. I want to look at this one here. So this one doesn't have any user interface type HTML overlay. What it is it's wholly and completely a Blender-created scene, and it is responsive. And so you can go ahead and look at that too. And so the way to look at these projects under the hood, if you look at the address here, if you start in your Blend4Web root directory, we can go to Deploy, Tutorials, and Examples. So let's take a quick look at that. So if we go to Blend4Web, Deploy, Tutorials, and Examples. So here, for example, is the cartoon interior. A real simple one to look at is, let's look at that interactive web application. So here is the various textures for that and the source blend file and web page integration. So if we were to open the blend file for this, we could see there it is. And so let's take a look at those and you can just see kind of how they're made. So one thing to be aware of is that the reason we're running a server on the local machine here is because the security settings of the browser don't allow it to run script from a separate domain. Essentially, what that means is it needs to run from a server. So once you start getting into JavaScript files, you need to test your project on a server. And the easiest way to do that is to spin up a local server. And so that's what's going on here. When you look at this directory, once the server has started, it's the default is localhost 6687. That's the root directory of your server, which is also the root directory of your Blend4Web SDK. And so that's what's going on there. So I think that is all the elements I wanted to cover with this video. So hopefully that helps provide you a pathway to getting started with Blend4Web. So if you get stuck on anything while you're discovering Blend4Web, head on over to the Blend4Web forum. There's a lot of folks there that can help you out. I hope to see you there. Thanks for watching.